Diabetes can cause physical and emotional issues that can affect your sex life. For women, the problem can be less obvious than it is for men. If you don't feel quite like yourself in the bedroom, there are things you can do to be more comfortable and at ease. Common problems. Dryness. Vaginal dryness is the most common sexual issue for women who have diabetes. High blood sugar levels can harden the blood vessels in the vaginal wall. That can affect lubrication and make sex uncomfortable. Prescription or over-the-counter vaginal lubricants can help. Less feeling. High blood sugar also can affect the tiny blood vessels that bring blood to your nerves. If those nerves don't work the way they should, you can lose some feeling in your vagina. That can make you less likely to get aroused or to have an orgasm. Vaginal infections. If your blood sugar isn't managed, you're also more likely to get a yeast or urinary tract infection. The itching, burning, and irritation they cause can make sex uncomfortable. See your doctor at the first sign of one of these infections. Depression. The challenges of managing diabetes can make you feel anxious or depressed. That can affect your desire for sex. Type 2 diabetes also can cause you to gain weight. That can affect your self-esteem. Therapy, medication, or a combination of both can help. What to do? If diabetes is affecting your sexual satisfaction, try these things to help. Keep your blood sugar under control. This can go a long way toward fixing many sexual problems. Vaginal dryness, yeast infections, and a decreased sex drive can all get better when your blood sugar levels are well managed. That can even help reverse some nerve damage. Third-party ad content. Talk to your doctor. Don't be shy. Your doctor can help narrow down the possible causes of your issues and suggest treatments. Some causes may not be linked to diabetes. Medications like antidepressants and blood pressure pills can also affect your sex life. If you're uncomfortable talking to your doctor about sex, see a doctor who specializes in sexual medicine. Talk with your partner. These issues can take a toll on your relationship, especially if you keep them to yourself. To keep your relationship with your spouse or partner on solid ground, it's important to talk about what you're feeling. Being open with your partner can help ease any tension that may be affecting your sexual relationship. It may even bring you closer together. You have type 2 diabetes. It's a tough diagnosis to hear. Once you're told, what should you do? First, take a breath. You may be surprised or even shocked, especially if your body feels the same as it always has. Some people feel scared, sad, or overwhelmed. When I was diagnosed, it hit me like a blow to my stomach. I couldn't believe it, says 65-year-old Lakshmi Popat, from Orlando, Florida. But after you have time to think, remember this. You can live a long, healthy life with diabetes. You may need to make changes to your daily routine, but it doesn't have to stop you from doing the things you want and need to do. Diabetes can be controlled, says Gregory Dodal, Maryland, of the Icahn School of Medicine at Mount Sinai Health System in New York. In addition to finding ways to live a healthier life, we have amazing tools that can help avoid complications. Get to the right mindset with these first steps. Accept the challenge. A shift in your thinking may help you feel better and move forward. Think of managing diabetes and improving your overall health as a tremendous challenge with a huge upside, Dodal says. Maybe you haven't been eating well or getting enough exercise. Maybe you need more of a work-life balance. Your diagnosis can be a wake-up call, in a good way. We often take our health for granted, Dodal says. But in the long run, it's difficult to accomplish all we do on a daily basis if we're not healthy. Third-party ad content. A change in mindset worked for Quinn Nystrom, a diabetes advocate in Baxter, Minnesota, who has been living with the condition for 18 years. When I learned that I was the only one that could determine the quality of my life, it changed how I looked at the world, Nystrom says. Diabetes didn't have to define me, I could use it to refine me. Continued. Get the facts. As you start diabetes care, you may hear a lot of topics and terms you don't know much about, like glucose levels, insulin, blood testing meters, or hypoglycemia. But there are many ways to educate yourself about the condition, and how to control it. National organizations, like the American Diabetes Association and the CDC, offer reliable information and resources on their websites. You can join an online community or an in-person support group. Also, ask your doctor for more information. Once you understand what's happening, you learn how to better help yourself, Popat says. By talking more with her doctor and family, she got a better handle on living with diabetes. Look to your healthcare team. You don't have to go through this alone. Your doctors are on your side, Dodal says. They'll give you tools and education to help you manage it. Make an appointment with a diabetes educator, who'll give you support and get you on the right track. She may. Continue reading below. Help you create a healthy lifestyle plan. Show you how to test and keep track of your blood sugar. Teach you about medication. Teach you how to buy supplies and use them safely. Watch for problems with your feet, skin, and eyes. To find a diabetes educator, ask your doctor for a recommendation. Or find one through the American Association of Diabetes Educators. Think about bringing a family member or friend with you to your appointments for support. Make small changes. If you try to overhaul your lifestyle with big sweeping changes, you may get overwhelmed or discouraged. Instead, take small steps. Go for a walk every night after dinner. Swap one unhealthy food or drink for a better option. Over time, small changes add up to results. Make changes you can live with long term. Find healthy foods that taste good and are easy to prepare. Choose physical activities you enjoy. If you smoke, talk with your doctor about ways that you can quit for good. You're more likely to stick with lifestyle changes when they're easier to take on. Continued. Ask for support. Your family and friends can be a big help as you handle your diagnosis and start to make changes. Talk to them about how you're feeling. Ask them to start new habits with you. Continue reading below. You can plan healthy family dinners and stock the pantry with good food choices. Try exercising together, too. Take evening walks, or buddy up for a gym class or morning swim. When you make plans with other people, you will be less likely to skip your healthy routine. I love going to my local YMCA and doing water aerobics with my friends, says Popat. They're the best support system, especially on days I don't feel like going. Most of all, give yourself time to adjust. It's normal to feel shaken up by your diagnosis. But as time goes on, you'll get used to your new normal. You may even be surprised how much better and healthier you feel.